So firstly, we have to try and make the wheels. Now here, we have two hubs, and we have two tires. This is what the hub looks like close up. And this is what the tire looks like. So firstly, we take one of the hubs and one of the tires, and then we slot them together like so. So they should click. And here you'll see there's quite a lot coming out in this end, and then almost none coming out. So we've got to push it further in. Ooh. And it can be quite difficult to get in. So you can see it's not quite the same all around. There are bits, there are hubs, parts of the hub actually coming out of the tire, and some which are stuck inside. So we push them in like so. So it should look like this in the end. Now we do the same for the other one. So we take tire, take a hub, and we put it in again. And then again, it's not quite the same all around. So we push it in again until it's all the same. And the production looks like this. So here are your two tires. Now we will take one of the axle pieces. We have two there, and these axle pieces should be the width of the tire. And what we're going to do is we're going to push these axle pieces into the hole of the wheel. It doesn't matter which way you put them in. It should work the same way. So only a little bit should be showing, and the other side should be relatively long. And then on that long side, we add one of these small bushings, and we place them in the long side, so, and push them in until it hits the hub. As you can see, do the same for the other one. I'm going to use a different side just to show you that it really doesn't matter which way you put in, it works the same way. So again, we push it through, and then, see, a little bit comes out. Oh, a bit too much. There we go. A bit, and on the long side, again, we take one of these bushings, and we push them through. There we go. The same result. So here we have two motors. These motors are in the EV3 kit. You can see they look like this. And here are the two tires that we made earlier. So now what we're going to do is we're going to take one of these motors and make sure it's like this. And then we take the long end and we place it through the middle of the motor. So it should go through like this. Oh, and it should click. And see, it should look like this. Now that's on one side. So we've got to do the same but on the opposite side. So we put them the same, so you can see in the same direction. Now we take the tire and we put it on the other end. So we hold it up and it should look like this before we start. And then we take the long side and we push it through the middle part of the motor again. And oh, there we go. It's going through and aha, it fits. So, it should look like this. And the final product should look like this. So for this part, we will need an EV3 computer brick. to look like this. The two motors that we prepared in the previous part, and we have four of these unique little connecting rods. And as you can see, there's a ridge in the middle, separating a shorter side from a longer side. So we take the computer brick, and it doesn't really matter which side we put it in. You can put it in this way, or you can put it in the other way. So we slot it in this hole on the corner, and we push it in like so, so it should click when it gets in. And then we take another one, and again, it doesn't matter which way you put it in, and then you plot it on the very end hole shown here. So we push that in until it clicks. So it should look like this. And now we are going to take one of the motors, preferably this one. So we push it in so that this connecting piece corresponds to this hole here, so it should go in like this. And then we line it up with the end one, so it would go through like this. So now we do the same with the other side. So we take two of the rods and we put them in the same hole. So we take one on the corner and push it in, and one on the end. So again, it looks like this. And then we take the motor with the tire facing out, and we push it in again like this. And then we'll go in. Sometimes it can take a bit of a wiggle. And now we make sure the knot, and that's perfect. So here we will have two bent beams. See here, there are two angles, and we're going to also have four short black connector rods. Now, as you can see here, these connector rods are very similar to the other blue connector rods, but instead of having a ridge two-thirds of the way across, this one has a ridge in the middle. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to take one of the connector rods, we're going to get one of these beams, and you can see there's the end where there are three holes, one of them crossed, and we're going to put one of these connector beams into the second hole. And it should click once it gets through. Then we will have a second connector rod and we place it into the angle. As you can see here. So now we're going to take what we've done so far with the EV3, and we're going to put these connector rods into these end holes here. So the three on the top would still be empty, and we're going to put them here. They should fit like so. Now we're going to do the same on the other side. Going to take this rod, except that instead of having all the connections on this side, we're going to put them on this side. So we take one of the connector rods, we place it in the second hole again. We're going to do the same with the second one. I'm going to place it in the angle. Sometimes it can be a bit fiddly to put in, but again, it should click as soon as it gets through. So now we're going to put it on the other side, so it should end up like this. Again, put it in and push it in, and it should click once it gets through. And so this is what it should look like. So you've completed this section. So now this is the last stage of the building process. Here we have two black cables. These black cables are the shortest ones you can find in the kit. The reason I chose them is because it makes the whole system a lot more compact, whereas if you use the larger cables, it will become quite messy. So we take the end of the cable. Notice how these cables have a tab on the top. It's clear. And we want to put that tab where you see that little cut-off section there. So we place it in like so. You can see. And then it should click as soon as we get in, so we know it's in that way. And the other end will go in the top of the EV3. So we have four slots here, A, B, C, and D. And we want to put this one again with the, again with the tab going into the side with the cutout. And we place it into slot number or letter B. It should click in. Now we do the same with the other side, except we're going to put it into slot C. Again, remember, tabs go in like so. Again, it clicks, and then we're going to put this into C. There we go. This is the completed build.